on ESPN Classic. It's Cobb, the film about the man widely regarded as the greatest and most vile baseball player of all time. Tommy Lee Jones is the aging Ty Cobb, who is looking for a writer to portray him contrary to public perception. Robert Wool is Al Stump, the journalist torn between reporting the truth or the story that the former player once written. Their relationship is an intense and dark saga, and you'll hear from the men that played them.
This screenplay does not moralize. That's probably its greatest strength.
I think you're really just going to enjoy a great, great character study.
It's Cobb, and it's now on ESPN Classic.
Welcome to Real Classics, ESPN Classic Sports Movie Show. Tonight's movie is Cobb, the astounding biographical journey of one of the nastiest cusses on the planet, who also happened to be baseball's best player ever, Ty Cobb. Hi, I'm Jeff Cesario. This is my co-host, the Mad Cherub, Norman Chet.
Indeed, Cobb was a bully and a bigot. He even shoots a cup of coffee at one point. I don't want to say this film is dark, but afterward, I went to see The Sorrow and the Pity for a pick-me-up.
Well, you know, but it's a good kind of dark. There's three real big reasons to watch this movie. Number one, style. This kind of movie is normally polite and slow. That's the way Hollywood likes it. But Cobb literally picks you up by the lapels and just slaps you around like a Chicago cop looking for someone to pin a rap on. Writer-director Ron Shelton made a martial arts flick and just left out the karate. Number two, Tommy Lee Jones. His energy level would tucker out Carrot Top. He shifts gears like a motocross racer, and yet you buy everything he says. He is fearless. And number three, the roadmap. This movie takes you the long way, the ugly way through Cobb's life, and it even slows down and shines the searchlight on the really, really hairy parts. If you're thinking on watching this with your kids, guess what? Think again. You're better off letting them play some video game where psycho geeks bite each other's heads off.
Ron Shelton, the man who only makes sports movies, directs Cobb, as Jeff mentioned. Shelton's also made Bull Durham, White Men Can't Jump, Blue Chips, and Tin Cup. He would have done Pride of the Yankees, but someone got to it first. Shelton was a player in the Baltimore Orioles minor league system from 1967 to 71. Cobb is based on a book by sports writer Al Stump, who was versatile enough to write the autobiographies of both Ty Cobb and golfer Sam Snead.
Wow, you have been spending your time in bookstores, buddy.
I'm impressed.
Listen, keep an eye out for Roger Clemens. He's in this movie, and he might be the only modern ball player ornery enough to have played back in the 20s and 30s, so his oeuvre matches up perfectly. Okay, the appropriate food for this movie is nothing. That's right, nothing. It's like a roller coaster. Don't put anything in your gullet before you ride it, even the TV version. So put your shrink's number on the speed dial, and without further delay, here's Cobb.
I'm Norman Chad, and you're watching Cobb, starring Tommy Lee Jones and Robert Wall. We now go to ESPN baseball analyst Peter Gammons, who sat down with Jones in this ESPN Classic conversation.
This is really a movie about Al Stump, is it not?
No. It's a movie about, there's several themes. The great Al Stump is... Not one of them. But then again, neither is the great Ty Cobb. They're important characters in a rather good movie that's partly about baseball.
But the dilemma of what we the public should know about heroes, isn't that really the
that's an
the
important theme? What we should or should not know, I don't know. This screenplay does not moralize. That's probably its greatest strength. It's not a movie that says you, the audience, should or should not do this or that.
Now, what about the actual hitting? I mean, did you go and practice? Did you spend much time
Lots.
Hitting left-handed?
A lot of time. We used batting cages. You know, they have batting cages now that are, you know, accessible to the public. And they throw at different speeds. They throw at 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, and 90 miles an hour. So if you find someone who knows a bit about hitting, you can... And why Cobb used the baseball grip that he did, someone who can coach you, then it's just a matter of applying yourself until you're able to create the illusion of hitting left-handed with Ty Cobb's split grip.
In the end, do you admire Cobb a lot?
Yes, a great deal.
Why?
Why not? We'll throw his achievement away, and we'll throw Ty Cobb on the ash heap of history. Why? Because he hated women, and he was a racist, and... He wasn't a nice guy, and he didn't always say please, and he was insanely, probably clinically insanely competitive. So let's just trash the man. Yeah, I can't bring myself to say that because I feel that I'm sophisticated enough to accept a man's virtues and ignore his vices.
Welcome back to Real Classics, the show that makes you think, hey, I could host that. Now, the movie we're watching, Cobb, is a completely unfiltered look at a bad man. Get a good look, because we may never see this again. Hollywood doesn't like making stories about jerks unless they get fried in the third act, and no modern athlete would ever give anyone the rights to something so harsh.
Yeah, like a modern comedian. I'm sure you'd let the full side of your story out.
Well, you know, if they kick with the high four figures, it's theirs, baby.
Of course, Cobb is often compared to Pete Rose. Cobb set the all-time record for base hits and played into his 40s. Rose broke Cobb's record and played into his 40s. Cobb had a spikes-up reputation of hurting other players. Rose separated Ray Fosse's shoulder in the 1970 All-Star game by barreling into him at home plate. Cobb was investigated for betting on baseball. Rose was given a lifetime ban for betting on baseball. But, you know, I don't think Rose is going to open the books on his life, Jeff. You're going to have to look elsewhere.
And even if a modern player did, quite frankly, Norman, so what? I mean, who's plunking down $10 to go see the Luis Polonia story or Strawberry? You know, when you hit a career 243, it just kind of takes the luster off. So relish every moment of this, folks. What do you say we get back to Cobb?
They say I used to show up in my spikes.
Georgia,
you're going to get hurt today, son of a...
The biggest help for me, once I got up on the mound, did a couple scenes, Ron put me in the director's chair and let me see myself, what I look like, and it takes you back in time with that old uniform. I remember being extremely hot, and I don't dip or chew, you know, and back then I guess they did, quite a few of them did, and they gave me, I asked for like black licorice or a Tootsie Roll to stick in my lip. So I could spit and it would look like it, you know, looked for real. And no one had any at the time. So one of the little guys ran up and all he had was chew. And I put a little pinch in there. And next thing you know, I was pretty dizzy. It was about 90 degrees and the humidity was high. And like I said, we were in those wool uniforms. And now I've got to throw a knockdown pitch in there at Tommy and make it look real. And, you know, he had the soft cap on. And I remember the very first take. I threw it up and in and it was too close. And I don't know how he got out of the way of it, but he did. And I was, I started to relax and not do my lines. And he came up off the ground and, you know, was laughing, kind of smirky, acting like Ty Cobb, you know, cocky, and started doing his lines. I thought he was going to come up and say, you know, hey, that was pretty close. And I was going to, you know, laugh it off, say, yeah, I'm glad you got out of the way. But he came up, started doing his lines, and it kind of flustered me. And so I had to get ready and start throwing some lines back at him. So, just great memories from it.
I like Cobb because I think it was more in touch with, obviously it was more, you know, of a biography of a player and understanding a player and his real life, what he did, how he was looked upon. And I thought that movie really pointed towards one of the great players in obviously in the 20th century.
I'm Norman Chad, and you're watching Cobb, starring Tommy Lee Jones and Robert Wall. We now go to ESPN baseball analyst Peter Gammons, who sat down with director Ron Shelton in this ESPN Classic conversation.
I had read the original Al Stone biography when I was 15, and then subsequently over the years started reading other things about Cobb that Stump was writing. An article, he was working on a biography, I got to know Al Stump and realized that this biographer had been in some ways obsessed with and devoted the rest of his life to trying to find out who Ty Cobb really was. And that's what the movie's about.
In doing the research, did you struggle at all about how you would present this?
Yes, it's a balancing act, because you want to show the monstrosity and the demons of Ty Cobb. If you rub the audience's face in it, they walk out of the theater. Sam Peckinpah used to say, I want the audience to keep wanting to leave but not be able to, because they're being seduced. And in a certain way, that was the fine line. I didn't want to romanticize him in any way. I also wanted to paint him as a complex human being, which I think he is. He's not a cartoon. He's not a robot. He was a man possessed by demons his whole life and wrestled with him from the day he was born until he died.
He was a genius, too, was he not?
Without question. He was an athletic genius. He was mentally brilliant anyway, off the field, but the way he played baseball approached genius.
Welcome back to ESPN Classics, Real Classics, special presentation of Cobb. I'm Jeff Cesario. This is Norman Chad. We are watching one heck of a movie written by Ron Shelton, who was a minor leaguer. Did he play minor league ball?
Yeah, he played minor league ball for about 4 years. And even though he never got out of the minor leagues, he certainly has made it into the major leagues when it comes to dialogue. Particularly, he has quite an ear because of his sports background, which is beyond baseball. He has quite an ear for sports dialogue and capturing it.
Boy, I'll say, these quotes, they just kill me. I have to read them. When he crashes the car, and a guy asks him if he's alive, Al Stump asks him if he's alive, and Cobb says, I wouldn't call it living, but it'll do. Then at another point, he says, life's too short to be diplomatic. Tells his own teammate, who signed you? He tells his own teammate who signed you. I love it. He also has a great quote, only great men are booed, which is wonderful. When Stump's in an argument with him, he says, I'll write slow, and Cobb says, I'll die slow. On Babe Ruth, Cobb says, he ran okay for a fat man. Now, the interesting things about this is, I'm guessing Cobb probably said none of these things. This is all Ron Shelton's writing, and great writing, because it feels like stuff Cobb would actually say.
Yeah, it's a combination of the two. We don't know, but when you put Cobb and Shelton together, you get kind of a dark statesman, a darker Winston Churchill, who just has the right thing for the right situation, word-wise.
Amazing. He may not have made it in the major leagues, but he's certainly a heavy hitter in script writing and in Hollywood. So why don't we take a look at more of his incredible writing right now? Let's get back to Cobb.
The great left-handed pitcher from the New York Giants.